first thing we see in 2013, this file menu. Okay. And you can see when we start this, our 2013 Excel, so we have this type of page, blank workbook. When you click from there, it will create a new workbook on your sheet, but it is not similar to Control N. When you press Control N, it is not similar to that. When you go to in your options, in advance, and you go down. There is a option, add startup, open all file in. You can give a path. Suppose you are using such kind of templates, you are working in something else, you have need to give quotations to clients, so you have quotation format. So you can choose that format and you can add the location here. Suppose I have kept a file here. I just made a template and saved to D drive, Airtel folder here as template Excel LT. Excel template. I save this file there by the name of book one. Oh, where it is? It got saved somewhere else.
You saved in Nokia folder, I think. Airtel folder, yes.
Yeah, I have saved, but it was not saved. So you can save the file and give their location to there. So you can open default templates from there by giving the path here to this folder. So it will automatically open that file when you press that button. And when you press Control N, it will activate the default option which you have chosen in your general tag, these options. Okay, well, that is not important actually.
Yeah.
So it has some features like flash fill. Suppose we have learned so much text formulas. Suppose I have typed some names here. Okay, now I want the initial of first name and rest I need this last name, full last name. Then I will press Control Enter, Control E. So you can see.
Okay.
Then I don't want this. What I want to do, I want my names in capital letters. So I will type. Okay. Control Enter, Control E. Okay. Now I want first initial of first name and last name.
This will not work in 2010, right?
Yes, it is in 2013. So Control Enter, Control E. But there is a problem. Now it is showing PP. So what we need to do, we have to give second example to this. PS. Control Enter. When we have done Control Enter, it automatically evaluates the other option. Okay. So this is a smart option that is called Flash Fill, which is introduced in 2013. Okay. With that, you also get some options like quick analysis. Suppose we have some names and some data you have here. When you select your data, there is an option here, you can see, that is called quick analysis, and there are a lot of options such as formatting options, you need data bar, color scale, icon set, all conditional formatting options are available here in your quick analysis. Then you have charting options. You can see the charts, different type of charts. Instantly you can create. Then you need subtotal, some average count, percentage, running total, sum, and many more. Running total, table, which type of table, pivot table. It shows you the sample here. Then spark lines. So lot of options are available related to formatting charts, subtotals, pivot table, and spark lines. This is called quick analysis, which is also introduced in our 2013. You want to create pivot table, you have options recommended pivot. When you select that, I need to restart it. When you go to recommended pivots, it shows you the different types of pivots here. Okay, which one is required by you, just select that. That's okay. The pivot will be created instantly without doing anything. Then you have recommended charts. In recommended charts, lot of charts are available here. It is also available in quick analysis, but there are a lot of more options available here. Which one you want, you can create instantly. Then you have a different feature here for formatting of charts and anything. You can choose your chart element here. You can choose the style from here, chart style. And you can filter your data also. Yeah. Okay. The charting filter is introduced in 2013. Okay. Now let's directly come to Power Pivot.
That VBA coding, can you send me after this class?
Yes.
The two power two ones.
Yes, I will send you. Somewhere hanging actually. So basically we have some data here in which we have customer data, where we have customer IDs, customer name and city. We have product data, we have product ID, product name and price. We have sales data, where we have sales ID, date, product ID, customer ID, and what quantity we sold. Okay, this can be your transactional data also. Okay, so each table is related to another one. Okay, so earlier we have only one option, that if we want to create pivot table, so we have all the data in one table only or one sheet. So what we do, we will do through VLOOKUP we get the values of product, through ID we can get the product name and product price, and through customer ID we can get the customer and city. So this we were doing through VLOOKUP method. Okay, but if you go through any database, you will find the table like this only. You need to do extra work with your VLOOKUP and formatting a lot of things. So in Power Pivot, you have such kind of linked table in Power Pivot. So first let me know that how to get that Power Pivot toolbar in any of the option. If you talk about 2010, there is an add-in for Power Pivot. You can download from Microsoft site and install it. And then how to activate that? Just go to options and go to add-ins, then choose COM add-in. Here in manage, you will choose COM add-in and press go. And here you have new option, Microsoft Office Power Pivot for Excel 2013. In Excel 2013, you will get Power Pivot only in professional version. Home version, personal version does not include Power Pivot. So I press OK and I get this Power Pivot toolbar here. Before starting Power Pivot, we have to convert all the tables, all the data in tables first. Okay, how to do that? Just select your data, press Ctrl T, and you will get that. Suppose you have some data here, press Ctrl T, create table option is there. My data has, table has headers, and you can change the name of the table from here.
What is the use of creating the table?
Actually, creating table can help you in adding new things, because it chooses its range dynamically. Suppose we are typing any new data here as 0404. So a line increased, a data range increased here. So we need not to select data all the time in normal pivot table. Or when we select the data from normal, we have to update the data all the time. We have to select a data source. When it is increasing, we need to select again and again. But if it is in table, you need not to select the data source again and again. It will be updated automatically when you do updation in your table. Okay.
Okay.
Then we just go in Power Pivot, and there we go in manage. When we go in manage, there is a separate window for Power Pivot. So it is just starting, it takes some time to start, because just like VBA, it has a separate window. So this is your Power Pivot window. So each data is being shown here. Each table, suppose we don't have tables here in this field. Here we can't update the data because it is for reference only. So there is no table now. it is a separate window from your data set. So we need to get the data first. So we go in diagram view. Data view, diagram view, and design advanced. Let's get that data first. Here we have the data is supposed to be there. One second. In this option we will select our data, this one, and add to data model. The first customer table is here. Then we again go to here and in product we select a click in between of the table and add to data model. Next table is here. Then we go to sales table and then add to model. Now the three tables are here. Now we have to tell Power Pivot that which cell is related to what cell. So we go in diagram view. Here we can find there are three tables. So we need to connect the IDs through its source. If I am talking about PID, because it is a transactional data of sales, so PID is related to this PID. I just drag this and you should keep in mind that this arrow movement should be to data source only. Then CID, we drag it to this CID. So you can see the both arrows are marked to its source. Okay, now
but this is doing in where it is in the workbook where the you have the original data, or it is a separate part?
It is a separate window of Power Pivot. Okay. Then you go to we have created actually a linked table here. So we go to and data view. And now we have some functions here also. So we just create pivot table first, then we will discuss about some functions which are useful. So there is in home tab there is pivot table, and when you click the pivot table it's asked should it be created in new sheet or existing sheet. So I have selected new sheet. So your pivot table is here. You will find there is three tables are here. Okay,
yeah, but this is created in where? In the existing workbook only?
Yes, in your real workbook. Okay, so
okay,
you have this data. Now what I choose,
we can create in the this workbook what the customer, product and sales. We will create, we will keep it as a like a data source, and the pivot can be created in another workbook.
This is a part of Excel, and this is for data management. For Power Pivot window is for just data management. You just relate the data with the different tables. Then when you click on this pivot table option, it will create a pivot table in your existing worksheet. So
it will not create in the another worksheet.
Yes.
So another workbook, I mean. Okay.
Yes. So we have three tables here: customer, product, and sale. Generally, we have only one table in our Excel sheet. So we have done so much linking. Now I choose city, and I want to know what quantity has been sold. So I just clicked in quantity and there is the total. Okay, because when you see the transaction data, there is no information about any city, there is only ID. Okay, but if you see in pivot table, I have chosen ID from customer table, city from customer table, and quantity from sales table.
Yeah.
So it automatically relates this CID to this customer ID and picked city from there and generated this report. So it is a very powerful tool which you can use in Excel. So I don't want to show here quantity, I want to show the total amount here, because the amount we have, the price we have, the product price we have in our product table, and in sales sheet we have transactional data about product. Okay, so I want to multiply quantity with the product price. So you can take help of this Power Pivot window, where you will go in this sales data, and there in new column you will add new column amount, and what will be the amount. First I will get the price actually, so let's change it to price, and I don't need to take VLOOKUP here, I need to just type one formula related. I type related, then I need to provide column name. So column name is price. So I type price. So in which table? Product price. The three IDs it is showing here. Product PID, price and product. So I choose price and close the bracket, enter. All the price are updated here. Okay, we don't need any VLOOKUP formula. Then we need total amount.
But this table is saved where, Sandeep ji?
In your Power Pivot window. It will not do any modification in your existing worksheet.
It will not do any. If suppose I will do some data changes in the existing worksheet, it will not reflect here, right?
If you do changes there, and you have to update, just click one button. Just let me complete, and I will.
Tell you. Sure. I have many questions on this actually.
So I can choose quantity from here, then multiply with price. Okay. Enter, and all the amount is updated here. Now I return to my Power Pivot. Update all. So when I click this update all button, all the things are here now. I want amount only. Okay.
Yeah.
So this is the use of Power Pivot. You can do lot of calculation in this Power Pivot window, which will not reflect.
But each and every time we have to start doing this linking and all, right? Or once you do it and you can save this this database, or I mean this kind of setup in one file or in the Power Pivot.
When you have created, just close it. Okay. Then this will work only. You need not to remember that there is a Power Pivot window. All the things are
we need
here.
Not work on. Okay.
If you want to see, just click on manage, you will find the same database. it does not require to saving in any other sheet.
But where it is saving this part?
In Excel.
This is in the same Excel only, same workbook only.
Yes. Actually,
okay.
We can say it is a compact SQL.
Okay. Uh-huh.
So you there are a lot of features which have been built in Excel now. Okay.
Mm.
This type of function.
My point is, my point is, my doubt is that suppose I have the three workbooks.
Okay.
And three workbooks always I am updating some data. One is transactional data, one is master data, and the other one is something like three workbooks. Okay. Oh. And those workbooks I don't want to touch. Always I will take the fresh one workbook and use those three workbooks as my database.
Okay.
Bring the data to another workbook and work, and whatever the reports I want it, I will make it, and like that we can do it?
Yes. We can just create a reference to that, and once we have created reference, we need not to remember that. It will automatically update here. Let's suppose we add some values here. So, date is same. Let's see what are the, I just include new name here.
No, in this case everything is in the same worksheet, workbook.
I have never tried actually, I will try that.
Okay, just let me know, because I have this, you are an expert in this one, so
yes.
Because I want to keep one for the customer, one workbook, product in one workbook, and sales in one workbook, presuming that three workbooks. I keep on updating these three workbooks as a master data. But when I want to submit my reports to my boss or my the colleagues, I want to open one normal fresh workbook.
Okay.
And which is link all these three sheets and get my report.
Yes, you can do it.
And that work report, I will send it to by email or someone.
So I have added some number here. Okay. Let's see. So if you do go in analyze and just refresh, then you can see the new city is added here. Okay. In simple updation. You just have to press this refresh button.
Yeah.
That's all you have to do. Once you have created your design in Power Pivot, it will be linked. And every update.
No, this point I understood, Sandeep ji. My question you didn't get, I think. If customer, product and sales is a different workbooks, and the sheet one is in a different workbook, always I will create the sheet one and send the reports to the various people. Okay. I don't want to give these master data to them.
See, what I am doing is, I just save this workbook and delete this Power Pivot. Okay. And
okay.
From somewhere else, I want to create.
Now you need to create one new workbook.
Yes.
Yes. This is what I want to understand. Yes.
No. First, we need to create a connection here.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. But let's go into Power. Let's directly. Right, directly go into Power Pivot, because there is
Sandeep ji, one
existing connection and from other sources.
Yeah. Which is the best, keeping the database in Excel or Access? Which is the best way of keeping the data, Sandeep ji?
The best way for keeping data, it is up to your requirement. If you have small data like 1 lakh rows or 60,000 or 50,000, less than 1 lakh, then you can manage on Excel. If you have
Okay.
more than that, then you will use excess till 1 crore.
Accesses. Oh.
Yes. After
Ah,
1 crore,
okay.
you can get some Oracle SQL type software.
Ah, okay.
Okay.
You know how to save the access data or some video you have something, then can you share me so?
Where?
Which is really, yeah.
How to save the Excel data?
Yeah, instead of like, you know, I extracted the data from the some SAP system and then I want to save it in Access, something like that, and then I want to use for this Power PBI or something, no? So
you can just copy paste it, because once you get in Excel, from Excel you can directly copy paste in Access. Or
Access. Oh, okay. Control paste, control V. Yeah.
Yes,
Okay,
yes.
that's fine. Yeah.
You can do like that. So let's try, because it needs ODC from other sources.
No, you have to use the existing connections. No,
no, there is no
connections from the data system.
No, the Excel file is there only.
Yeah.
From other sources.
Connection from data.
From other
from
sources.
Other sources. Yeah.
Excel
Yes.
file.
Yeah. Excel file. Yeah.
Next. Browse and in desktop. I'm doing it first time actually. Power Pivot. Open. Test connection. Okay. Next.
Use the
we
first
have
row as a column
we
header.
have these three tables. Here.
Yeah.
I selected this. Then finish. Importing. Okay.
Yes. Yeah.
Close. So we have done. But what one problem is there? You can see there is no header.
Yeah, you have to select that tick box.
Yes.
No, when you are yeah.
Just delete that again and let us do with see if there is a header option or not. From other sources, we Excel file, next, browse, Power Pivot, use first row as column header. There is a
yes.
Next, all the tables, finish. Close. Now we have proper data. Okay. So in our sales data we can use that.
Okay, that's not needed. I understood this point, yeah.
Okay. So you can do like this, but one thing important that
this data will be say this hist this data is saved in this the new workbook. When you just run the pivot table,
new work.
Okay, just common normal pivot table. Yeah.
Okay.
For the workbook, no? Yeah.
Okay. Let me just delete that. Right. Delete. Okay, pivot table, new. There are three tables.
New
okay.
Worksheet. Yes, fine.
So I choose city from here. There are few the column which are not ready needed. So it is there.
Because you didn't link it, no?
Relation.
No, you already done the linking.
No, we have not done. That's why it is that relationship
okay.
between. So you can create from here also.
Okay.
So we have sales table. Foreign key will be my PID, and which is looked in product PID. And one another relationship that is sales CID, which will be looked in customer CID. Now it is correct. Okay.
Yeah. Now I'll save this file, send it to somebody else. They can able to access entire this customer data sources or no?
No, they can't access because it should be in local system.
Okay, suppose the person who is received, if he double click that first Agra 584, if they double click, they will get the full data?
Yes.
Yeah, double click. Yeah.
They will get.
Okay, they can get it, but they cannot see the entire database.
The entire database, if they have, they can see.
Like a customer product sales, we have the master file. So these stuff they cannot see.
They can see.
They can see that. Okay.
Yes. They can see.
Okay.
Okay.
We can protect the Power Pivot database.
That much I don't know. I will research on that.
Okay, because it is
a new feature, totally new feature that I am telling to you.
No, Power Pivot we have in the Excel 2010 as well.
No. After yes, there is, but it is created recently.
Okay.
And there are
okay.
Not much, not that extent that. The tutorials are available on that. In fact, if you can see in your, there is only one tutorial on YouTube.
No, I have seen that. Yeah.
By Mr. Excel.
Because I am very much interested in this Power Pivot and VLOOKUP. These are the two exhaustively I am using in the office works. And in Power Pivot, my normal pivot table, Sandeep ji, I have one question.
Okay.
See, you have this, yeah, Agra, Ahmedabad, Allahabad, like this, you have the play, this thing.
Yeah.
I can hard code these names, and can I get this, the C column data there? If there is no data also, this should not change, like, you know that. If Agra data is not there, then it will reduce, compress that.
Yes. You want that if there is no data, it should display zero.
It should be there like that. It's like hard coded that column. I mean the rows.
You can do that.
Okay. It will help actually, because each and every time I'm giving some new formulas or copy paste, it is changing for me. That's
no. You have something. First, you create some raw data.
Okay.
I'm not able to copy this data. Okay. Yes. Paste. Here, what I'll do,
yeah.
I'll just do this thing equal to and select this here. I'm clicking on that and enter, so I get the same thing. So,
yeah,
we have an option.
But here the problem is, yeah, if I double click, I will not get the full database of that.
See, what's the problem?
Like 584, if I double,
Yes, you will not get the whole data.
Yes.
You can use this option, get pivot data. There is a function and you can customize this one. Measure dot sum of quantity. Okay. So where is the city? You can choose it from any reference. From where? This one. From there you delete this thing and get it from here. Okay, it's not working. What was that? I will do on that, because this is the only option for doing that.
Okay, we cannot do something in drill down option. We won't get it.
Yes.
But VBA we can do it, Sandeep ji. You have any idea about that?
What do you want to do actually? You want to display the data.
This summarize Ahmedabad, these things I want to fix it, the static one. Whether the data is there, not there, those things should be there in my report.
So you can use some summit function.
Yeah, some ifs we can, yes, the problem with the end of the day some ifs also, if I double click the 584, I will not get the full details of this 584, how many transactions are there, no?
Okay, for
yeah, you understand my point. See, basically I want
suppose
say 584, I feel that it is an extraordinary transaction, like you know, the 584 value is more, then I want to know that what are the transactions behind on this.
Yes.
So if I double click, I will get in the one sheet.
You can do with your VBA, but it will be very complicated.
Okay.
Because
okay.
Excel has developed lot of function over there, and they have really very hard work for getting this data. So
okay,
we will face problem in doing that. Okay, but we can do by this way. We will take more time, but we can do this thing.
Okay.
So sir, that was an intro to your 2013's new feature. And if you want to have more expertise on 2013, then you can see the videos on YouTube. There is some videos.
No, 2013 I'm not using, because office I'm using 2010. That they are not give the this thing, so there's
so
no point.
For
again,
Power Pivot, you have.
Yeah, Power Pivot. Yes, I have seen the videos actually. Yeah.
So you have Power Pivot, and lot of options are available. Not on a single video, there are lot of videos on that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
By Chandu, but I am not comfortable with Chandu. He is very he actually do not tell the secret. He always sell his product. Okay, so we will meet tomorrow, and we will start VBA tomorrow. Okay sir.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, and can you send this two codes, VBA codes, so tomorrow I'll just look.
I have typed that. Okay, I have not
already closed it, I think.
Yes. So there is nothing actually special.